Insects this year, mostly driven by the early high temps. We saw populations rise pretty quickly. We've seen a lot of the beetle populations, aphid populations, were a little higher this year. Beetle populations maybe not a little higher, but certainly a little more active, and certainly active a little earlier this year. And a lot of that had to do with heat and our weather conditions. And what's going on here is a lot of our insect populations, including Colorado potato beetle and our aphids, are controlled earlier in the season by what are called entomopathogenic fungi. It's a fancy word we use to just mean fungus that kills insects. And unfortunately, these fungal diseases are all adapted for cold, damp conditions. Neither of those describe our early season this year. So a lot of those fungal diseases didn't get started. We saw high survivorship of earlier stages of Colorado potato beetle. We saw high survivorship of aphid populations. They were able to grow. And that was one of the reasons we saw kind of elevated populations this year. The other is everything that happens to an insect is kind of controlled by temperature. They're not warm-blooded like we are, so our physiological processes, our digestion, our, you know, basically everything that's going on in our body physiologically is controlled within a very narrow temperature range. And if it goes much beyond that temperature range, we start to get a fever, things start to not operate so well. Insects have to be an awful lot more, well, the biological word is plastic. They have to be able to tolerate broader ranges. And the reason for that is they're cold-blooded. Everything that's going on with them is run by the ambient temperature. As the temperature rises until it gets to a certain point, all that happens is their physiology starts to increase. So they digest faster, which means they're going to eat more. They start being more active. Not only that, but their reproductive time becomes a lot shorter. So we saw turnover of generations a lot more quickly this year. We didn't see that the mortality in the younger individuals early. We have this heat coming on, which means they're feeding more, they're also reproducing more, they're laying more eggs, but they're also developing faster. And so our generation time on those insects became shorter as well. You put all these things together and what you end up with is high populations in dry, hot years. We see it in a lot of species. Grasshoppers, big grasshopper problem towards the end of this year. All of that was because we were not seeing mortality of those early grasshoppers with those fungal diseases. So that's kind of where we're seeing those tall numbers, those higher numbers. It got to the point in certain parts of the state that, you know, Colorado potato beetle, we like to think of those summer adults that pop out late July, early August. We like to call that our second generation. It's really not. We have really one true generation per year. They overwinter as adults. They come out, they move into the potato fields, they mate and lay eggs. You have larvae. After feeding for a few weeks, those larvae will drop to the ground. They pupate, and the adults come out in, you know, July to August. That's actually the beginning of this year's generation, but that's actually the adults from this year's generation, and they're the ones that overwinter. So in Minnesota, we actually have one true generation most years. This year, right now down in Central Min, we're watching our second flush of adults. So this is a true second generation. When that happens, I doubt if it's going to happen up here, but when that happens, what it means is you've got twice the load of adults going in and overwintering. So next year's season might be starting off with a big bang as far as adult beetles coming into the field is concerned. So a lot of the stuff that's been happening with our weather is going to really affect our insect populations. And kind of that straightforward. With aphids, what we're seeing, if you're a sea potato grower and you're interested in PVY vectors, our situation right now is very similar to where we were last year, but the good news is we're starting to see populations drop, and that was because we did see that early season development. Not only does that heat drive insect populations, it actually leads to early maturation of a lot of our crops as well. Our crops seem to mature a little bit faster. That was certainly the case with small grains. That meant we had an early flush of aphids moving from small grains into potatoes. That's now over. We had an early harvest of small grains, so those small grain aphids are no longer flying. So that's kind of a good news. We saw a large rise pretty quickly, but I don't think it's going to rise any further up here. I think we're starting to see the end of those vectors. It's kind of been decreasing for the last 3 weeks. But again, directly related to the heat and the humidity, or heat and lack of humidity, lack of precipitation. So everything that's going on with our climate is certainly going to impact our insect populations, especially the ones that are going to be in our fields. So anybody got any questions? I know it was pretty quick, but some other good news. We're doing a lot of trials this year on products. I won't be talking about what they are, but I can tell you that there's some very, very promising products that are in the line that should be out. So this is very good news for Colorado potato beetle when we're talking about a very limited number of active ingredients being available to us. So we're having to go through those rotations. Hopefully we'll have a couple of more tools in the toolbox in the next few years.